All right, guys, single arm kettlebell snatch. So basically, when we're snatching something, it doesn't matter whether it's a barbell, kettlebell, dumbbell. It means the movement is basically one nice, big, fast movement, either from the ground or from above the knee, up over the head and locking out overhead in one movement, basically. So that's how we're going to describe the snatch. So it's nice and easy for you guys. So with the kettlebell, basically we introduce a little bit of a kettlebell swing, and then instead of taking the bell out in front like we do with the kettlebell swing and either stopping it at the eyes or shoulder level and taking it over the top into a full kettlebell swing, we still take it from the start position of the kettlebell swing, but instead of making a big round trajectory to your lockout position, we're going to swing with the elbow nice and high, pull on that bell, and as that bell starts to become weightless, then we roll and punch that kettlebell through the ceiling. Okay, so it's really, we're still doing a kettlebell swing, but we're just getting there a little bit of a different way. So it relies on a lot more hip speed and hip power, and obviously full strength in the kettlebell swing. Okay, so I'll demo the kettlebell swing first, just so you can see the correlation between the two, and then I'll move into the kettlebell snatch. Okay, so again, single arm kettlebell swing, pick the bell up, all right, get your feet nice and stable, and get those hips going, and just swinging the bell up to shoulder or eye level or wherever you feel comfortable with. Okay, so the start of the kettlebell snatch is basically the same as the start of the kettlebell swing. We're still going to hinge forward and get our hips doing all the moving, but instead of pushing the bell out in front, we're going to pull on the bell, nice high elbow, and roll and punch the kettlebell above the head like so. Alright, so the way I want you to bring it down is nice and tidy down to a front rack, alright, and then pour the kettlebell like you're going to pour a jug of milk or a jug of water over and back between the legs. Okay, that's the way I want you to lower that kettlebell, alright, until we get sort of the hang of it, and then we can start taking it from over the head and straight down through the legs. Okay, so again, just to hash on that movement, hips firing up, ready to pull the elbow nice and high, elbow comes up, and I roll and I punch my hand through the ceiling, okay? And what I mean by that is, if I don't roll the kettlebell over and punch it to the ceiling, what's gonna happen is, it's because the kettlebell's underneath the hand in the swing, and then at the lockout position, the kettlebell has to come around the hand, like so. We get to here and we don't punch our hand, what happens is that kettlebell falls and it sort of whacks us on the back of the arm or the forearm. Alrighty, so, and look, it's not going to break your arm, it's not going to cause you any damage, but it'll probably bruise your arm and it'll start to get a little bit tender, and we want to sort of avoid that. So what I mean by roll and punch is, as I'm pulling on that kettlebell from down below, my elbow's high, the kettlebell comes up, I roll my wrist, and then as the kettlebell is starting to come over, I punch my arm up and lock that kettlebell out. What that does is, it beats the kettlebell from tipping over and whacking against the arm. It actually beats it and meets it halfway. Alrighty, so the kettlebell doesn't have to fall so far from here all the way down and whack me in the arm. It only has to fall from about here, and that's when I pick up that punch. Alrighty, so it's really, really important to get that punch right, okay? If you're not comfortable with the kettlebell doing the snatch, just do it with a dumbbell. It's the same movement, alrighty? Obviously, you can hold the dumbbell in an overhand grip, and you're always attached. attached to it, so there's no rolling and dropping of the dumbbell. Okay, either way, you're still going to get that nice, good, explosive hip power out of the movement. Try it with a lighter weight when you first start, so you do have a lot more control over that roll and punch. And then once you start to feel comfortable with that, change the weight and go up. Cool.